Good morning, children. Yesterday we were discussing about magnetic effect of electric current, mechanical effect of electric current. Then we discussed about a device which converts electrical energy to mechanical energy. That device we called it as electric motor. And we discussed that we can break. So we discussed the working of electric motor. There we had one coil connected to two split rings, which in turn will be connected to carbon brushes, and that carbon brushes will be connected to the power supply. So whenever we pass current through the coil, two equal and opposite forces will be acting on the conductors, or the conductors which are perpendicular to the magnetic field. So when two equal and opposite forces will act on the coil, then it will tend to rotate. It will tend to rotate. This is how it will be converted from electrical energy to mechanical energy. So with every half of the rotation, there will be a change in the direction of current. So this this change in direction of current will enable it to rotate in the same direction. Once again, it will be changing. We will be changing it in the changing the direction of current through a commutator, which will enable it to rotate in the same direction. So now, how can we increase the speed of rotation or the force acting on the coil? Simple, increase the magnitude of current, increase the number of coils. This is how we can increase the speed of the coil. So we converted electrical energy to mechanical energy with the device called as electric motor. So this is what I am. Yesterday, before starting the class, I just gave you an idea how the magnetic field will be created, or magnetic field will be set up around a current carrying conductor. So we discussed that when an electric field is in motion, then that will change to magnetic field. This is what we discussed yesterday. Now, Michael Faraday, the great scientist, did the reverse way. So this is the reverse way, means what he did? He moved the magnetic field linking with the coil. Then he saw what effect it will show. What he did, he took a magnet and he moved that magnet into the coil. So there, what is happening? The magnetic field is in motion or not? The magnetic field will be linked with the coil and it will be in motion. He observed that there will be a small deflection in the galvanometer, which suggests that connected to that coil, which suggests that there is a flow of current. So for the flow of current to happen, what should be there? There should be a potential difference. Then he concluded that whenever you move magnetic field, whenever you make the magnetic field to move inside the conductor or outside the conductor, or not outside, pull it out of the conductor, then there will be a change in the magnetic field with linking the coil. When there is a change in the magnetic field linking the coil, he concluded that there will be a potential difference set up in the coil, which enables the electrons to move in the coil, setting up electric current. So this phenomena, where a moving magnetic field will induce a potential difference in the coil and make the electric current to flow through the circuit, that phenomena is called as electromagnetic induction. These were the small simple experiments which were conducted, or which were done by Michael Faraday. We study those simple experiments and to understand what is this electromagnetic induction. Now, I'll go to the first experiment. So you can see here, I have a coil with so many terms. Okay, I have a magnet and I have connected that coil to a galvanometer to show whether there is a flow of electric current out there. To understand whether there is a flow of electric current or not. Now what I will do, I will take this magnet. So when there is a magnet, then obviously there should be magnetic field around it or not. So when there is a magnet, obviously there should be a magnetic field around it. And when I move the magnet, or Michael Faraday, what he did, he moved this magnet into the coil. He moved this magnet into the coil. When he moved this magnet into the coil, he observed that there is a deflection in the galvanometer. So what that shows? That shows that
and potential difference was set up in the coil. Potential difference was set up on the coil and current flowed through the circuit. And that flow of current is indicated by the galvanometer. Okay, so this showed that a current flowed in the circuit when there is a movement of magnet inside the coil. Okay, I'll sum up how what it happens. So when there is a movement of magnet inside the coil, he observed that there is a deflection in the galvanometer. So what are the conclusions we can draw from this? The conclusions we can draw from this is, whenever you are moving a magnet inside the coil, then a potential difference will be set up in the coil, and that potential difference will make the current to flow in the circuit. So that current, the flow of current, will be indicated by the galvanometer. Now let us understand how this is happening. Now what will be there around the magnet? Simple, there will be a magnetic field around the magnet. So when we are moving that magnetic field into the coil, that magnetic field linked with the coil is in motion, then a potential difference is set up. That potential difference, what it will do? It will enable the current to flow through the circuit. So this phenomenon is called as electromagnetic induction. Now let us try to draw the parallel here. So yesterday we saw that whenever there is a charge in motion, whenever the charge is moving, so yesterday, if you remember, I showed you one small example. I took a positive charge. I said that there is an electric field around this charge, and then when this electric field is in motion, that is what is current. When this electric charge is in motion along with the charge, what is moving? There is the electric field is also moving, and that electric field will change to magnetic field when it is in motion. That is what we studied yesterday. So a moving electric field will induce a magnetic field around the conductor. This is what we studied. The same way here, in the parallel way here, now what is happening here? Here a magnetic field is moving. A magnetic field is moving, and that magnetic field will induce the potential difference. Induce the potential difference means it is giving the energy to the electrons to move in only one direction. That is what we constitute electric current. So this phenomena is called as electromagnetic induction. Now let us try to make it simple here. Now a magnetic field linked with the coil in motion will induce an electromotive force, or will induce a potential difference in the coil, which will drive the electrons. That moment of electrons is nothing but electric current. So this is how we generate electric current. Now what he did, what magnifier did, first he moved it into the coil. Then what he did, he pulled it back. He pulled that magnet back. So when he pulled that magnet back, what happened once again? Once again, the magnetic field linked with the coil changed, or the magnetic field linked with the coil moved. Okay, but in what direction? But it moved in the opposite direction. Okay, but it moved in the opposite direction. So that current also will flow in the opposite direction. So there will be a deflection of galvanometer in the opposite direction. So when you move forward, the deflection of the galvanometer will be in one direction. When you move back, then the deflection will be of the galvanometer will be in the other direction. And one more thing also you observe. This movement of the galvanometer will be seen only when the magnet is moving. When the magnet is stationary, or when the magnet is idle, there is no movement of the galvanometer, which shows that there is no flow of current. So what we can conclude? A moving magnetic field will induce a potential difference in the coil, and that potential difference will drive the electrons through the circuit, enabling or making it electric current, which can be noted by this galvanometer. So through three things we can conclude here. So when you move forward, there will be deflection in the forward direction. When you move back, there will be deflection in the opposite direction. When the magnet is stationary, there will be no deflection in the galvanometer. So these are the three points we can draw from this simple experiment. Now let us go a bit deep here to understand what will happen. Now when you are pushing this magnet, what we discussed that there will be an potential difference in the there will be a potential difference induced in the coil, and current will start to flow. So when currents will start to flow, what will be there around the coil? Obviously there will be a magnetic field around the coil. Okay, remember that there will be a magnetic field around the coil. And remember that that pole of the magnetic field will be always the same pole which is nearer to the coil. For example, now I have taken south pole here. So what magnetic pole will be here? Here also it will be south pole only. So when it is south pole, what this south pole will do? This south pole will push this magnet back. So always we should keep applying that mechanical force. So what are we doing here? We are converting that mechanical force into electrical energy. Okay. So let us come to that later. We will study that in detail. So what we should understand here, whenever there is a movement of magnetic field linked with the coil, there will be a potential difference induced, and that potential difference will enable the current to flow through the circuit, and galvanometer, there is a deflection in the galvanometer. When they pull the magnet back, once again there is a change in the magnetic field linked with the coil, once again there will be a deflection in the opposite direction. So once again there is a flow of current, but remember always the pole that will be induced due to the magnetic field, I repeat it slowly once again, the pole that will be induced due to the magnetic field, due to the flow of current, will always be the same pole nearer to the coil. Okay, so that will actually that will be in line with the law of conservation of energy. So always we should, this will be repelling this one, but we need to be applying force to push it, that one. So this is called electromagnetic induction. Now this is one experiment we have studied. Now let us study the second experiment. So in this second experiment, if you observe, I have two coils here. Let me call this as primary coil and this is secondary coil. Okay, this is primary coil and this is secondary coil. Now you can see here, I have connected this primary coil to a source of energy through a key. Okay, I have connected this primary coil to a source of energy through a key, and this secondary coil I have connected to a galvanometer. Now what will happen? Now what I do? I close the key. So what will happen? The current will start flowing. Now let us take turn by turn here. Now as the current is starting to develop, as the movement of electrons is happening in that turn, then what will happen? There will be a magnetic field induced in it. Okay, there will be a magnetic field around the turn. Similarly, when the current has reached a steady state, that means when the current is has reached a steady state, there will be a magnetic field or not. Okay, but as the current is growing, the magnetic field will keep on changing or not? I take turn by turn here. One turn, the magnetic field is induced here. Once again, it is going to the second turn. Once again, the magnetic field is induced there. So as it is moving, there will be a continuous change in magnetic field. This change in magnetic field, when it is linked to the another coil which is connected to a galvanometer, what will happen? There is a change in magnetic field. So what is happening? Potential difference will be induced in this coil and current will flow through the circuit. Why potential difference is induced? Because a changing magnetic field, as the current is developing in the coil, there will be a change in the magnetic field, and that changing magnetic field, when it is linked with the secondary coil, will induce a potential difference in the coil, and that induced potential difference will enable the current to flow through the circuit, which will be indicated by the galvanometer. Now let us go to the other process, and the reverse process. What I do now, I will remove the key. So when I remove the key, as the current grew, the same way the current also will die from coil to coil. As the current is dying from coil, turn to turn, then what will happen? There will be once again change in the magnetic field, and that changing magnetic field will once again induce potential difference in the coil.
okay, and that induced potential difference will once again drive the charges, which will constitute electric current. Okay, but once again the reflection will be in the reverse direction, because the induced potential difference will be in the reverse direction, because it is dying now. Earlier the current was making up or growing. In the second case it was dying. When I opened the key, the current was dying. So this, what we can conclude here is the changing magnetic field, when it is linked with the conductor or when it is linked with the coil, will induce a potential difference in the coil which will enable the current to flow through the circuit. That phenomena is called as electromagnetic induction, and this is absolutely reverse to the phenomena of what we studied yesterday. Yesterday we studied that there is a movement of electric field which induces magnetic field around the conductor. Here a moving magnetic field is inducing electric current. Okay, is inducing potential difference, in turn electricity is, or electric current is flowing through the circuit. Okay, this phenomena is called as electromagnetic induction, and this was discovered by the great scientist. As I yesterday told you, we didn't have any formal education. In spite of that, he discovered this phenomena of generating electricity or converting mechanical energy into electrical energy. Okay, so now next next topic we will study what is the device which converts this mechanical energy into electrical energy. That device is called as electric generator. So we understood what is electromagnetic induction. So what is electromagnetic induction? Whenever the magnetic field linked with a coil is in motion, then it will induce an potential difference in the coil, which will result in the flow of electric current in the coil, which is indicated by a galvanometer. This is what we have studied. Michael Faraday, we have studied that Michael Faraday was the one who discovered that one. Say if I keep the magnet constant or stationary and make the coil to move, what will happen? The same thing will happen, right? Once again, a magnetic field will be there around the conductor, and when you are moving coil, keeping the magnet stationary, what will happen? That magnetic field will get disturbed. So when that magnetic field gets disturbed, what will happen? Once again, potential difference will be induced in the coil, which will result in the flow of electric current. Okay, and now the question arises, how to find out the direction of electric current? Very simple. Once again, to find out the force on a current carrying conductor, we used the Fleming's left hand rule, where we discussed that we have three fingers stretched perpendicular to each other, such that this finger will give us, or the four finger will give us the direction of magnetic field. The middle finger will indicate the direction of electric current, then the thumb will indicate the direction of motion of the conductor. Now, to understand the direction of electric current, use Fleming's right hand rule. There is a rule called as Fleming's right hand rule. That Fleming's right hand rule states that stretch the first three fingers of your right hand such that they are perpendicular to each other. So when they are perpendicular to each other, such that this thumb is indicating the direction of motion of the conductor or motion of the coil, this finger or the forefinger will indicate the direction of magnetic field, then the middle finger will give us the direction of electric current or induced electric current. Once again, I will discuss this one. Stretch your the first three fingers of your right hand such that they are perpendicular to each other, such that your thumb is indicating the direction of current, direction of motion of the conductor. Your index finger or the first finger will indicate the direction of magnetic field. Then your middle finger will indicate the direction of induced electric current. So this will give us the direction of induced electric current. Now let us apply it onto a device. We'll take a device and we'll see whether electricity can be generated. That device, what we are learning now, is nothing but the AC generator. So this is an indicative diagram, just an indicative diagram. I'll share you on a video, a 3D video in your group, so that you can watch it very nicely. YouTube video it is. You can watch it very nicely. You can understand both DC motor as well as the AC generator. Both I'll share you. Okay, just this is the indicator diagram what I am showing here. Now, these N and S are the poles of the magnet. So, we have kept one coil A, B, C, D in between the poles of a magnet. That is, we have kept it in the magnetic field. We have kept this coil in the magnetic field. We have mounted this coil on two rings. These are full rings. They are not like the split rings what we have studied in DC motor. They are full rings here, ring R1 and ring R2. Okay, so that rings R1 and R2 are connected to the external circuit by the brushes B1 and B2 respectively. R1 is connected to B1 and R2 is connected to B2. R2 is connected to B2. So here, now, what we should do? We should make the coil to rotate. So how to make the coil to rotate? Using some external force, you rotate this axis. Okay, you rotate this axis. So this axis will start moving in this direction, such that AB is moving in the upward direction, while CD is moving in the downward direction. When AB is moving in the upward direction, CD is moving in the downward direction, then apply your Fleming's right hand rule. Okay, when you are applying the Fleming's right hand rule, what will happen? So the current should flow from A to B, C to D, and D to R1. R2 to B2, and once again it's complete the circuit by going to B1. Okay, so I'll discuss. We have kept one coil in a magnetic field, stationary magnetic field. That coil we have named it as A, B, C, D. Okay, we have named it as A, B, C, D. So we have mounted this coil on rings R1 and R2, which are in turn connected to brushes, carbon brushes B1 and B2 through the external circuit. Now what we should do? We should move the conductor, or we should move the coil, we should rotate the coil. So by using a handle, we can rotate the coil through the axle such that this AB is coming in the upward direction while CD is going in the downward direction. Then applying your Fleming's right hand rule, you will see that the current will flow from A to B, C to D, and C to D to ring R2 to B2, and it will complete the circuit coming to B1. So the current in the first half of the rotation will flow from B2 to B1. Okay. So what will happen now? After the first half of the rotation, then coming to the second half, the direction of this one will rotate, or the coil will be different. So what will happen in the second half of the rotation? This CD will be coming in the upward direction, while AB will be going in the downward direction. So once again electricity is generated, but the current will flow from DCBA. It will flow from DCBA to B1 to B2. So what we are understanding here, the polarity of current will change with every half rotation of the coil. So after half rotation, the polarity will change, or the polarity of the current, AC current will, current will change. This changing of polarity with every half rotation is called as alternating current. It is called as alternating current. So the polarity, if I want the current to flow in only one direction, simple, use a commutator here in the external circuit, which will make the current to flow in the same direction or in only one direction, that is called as direct current. While this current generated from this device is called as AC current, that is alternating current. Okay, that alternating current is, what is the unique feature of alternating current? The polarity of the current or the direction of current will change with every half rotation. Okay, it will change with every half rotation. Okay, this current, this is what is the current we'll be getting into our phones, which is called as AC, alternating current, at 220 volts. Okay, now what is exactly happening? What is the principle involved here? Simple, there is a magnetic field going here. So when the coil is rotating, it is disturbing the magnetic field, and that disturbed magnetic field, we can also call it as magnetic flux. So that disturbed magnetic field or magnetic flux will be linked with the coil, so that according to our electromagnetic induction, our principle of electromagnetic induction, potential difference will be induced in the coil, and due to that potential difference, current will flow. As simple as that. Okay, so but the only thing what you should understand here is with every half rotation, the direction of current or the polarity of current will be changing, and that polarity of the change or polarity of current can be made into only one direction by using a commutator. Okay, so this is the principle of AC generator. So coming and this ends. Now I will be ending this chapter here. One more, we have one very small topic called as domestic circuits, which I will show you some videos and make you understand when you come back to the school. So here I end the chapter. Okay. So today I'll be sharing you AC generator, DC motor. Please go through those YouTube videos. Try to understand. If you have any doubts, please come back to me or please message me. I'll clear your doubts. Okay. Now when we look at both the chapters what we have studied till now, that is electricity and magnetic effects of electric current. In electricity, what we have studied? We have studied about current, potential difference, resistance, resistivity. Then we studied about combination of resistors. Then we studied about power. We studied about heat dissipation, or we studied about heating effect of electric current there. Then in the second chapter, we studied about magnetic effects of electric current. First we studied about magnetic effect, then we studied that a current carrying conductor, when it is placed in a magnetic field, will experience some force, okay, or tends to experience some force. That we studied, that we call it as mechanical effect of electric current. Then we discussed about the directions there, how what will be the direction of force. That force we discussed about, we discussed that with Fleming's left hand rule. Then we came to DC motor, we studied about DC motor. Then we discussed about electromagnetic induction. So electromagnetic induction, using that principle, we studied a device called as AC generator today. So what I want you to understand here is, the first chapter you have so many equations. So whenever the paper setter wants to give problems, he will focus on your first chapter. Whenever he wants to ask you the questions based on applications, then he will come to your second chapter. So be very precise on what you are learning. Here you don't have any expressions in the second chapter. You don't have any calculation of magnitudes here. You are only discussing about the directions here. So be very clear on what you are learning in every chapter. So this ends the chapter, magnetic effects of electric current. As I told you, I'll be sharing two very important videos from YouTube today. So please go through those videos, try to understand what is electric motor and then what is electric AC generator. Okay. So from tomorrow, day after tomorrow, your sir will start a new chapter, Lingra sir will start a new chapter. So after he completes this chapter, there will be one more chapter left which I will be handling. Thank you. Thank you.